There is absolutely one problem almost all day traders have, which is finding the direction of the market. And in this video, I'm going to make it easier and more simple for you guys to know the direction of the market effortlessly. And yes, I'm going to be doing that with a strategy. So I'm going to give you guys a strategy, but I'm not just giving you guys random new strategy, because if you check on my channel, I've been showing you guys some strategies, and those things are actually the same thing. If you watch it, it's still the same thing, but in depth, more review. So basically what I'm going to do here is that I'm just going to give you guys the cumulative, everything summed up together to form a whole strategy, which is the Malvin 2.0. so this is the Malvin 2.0 strategy. And if you check, you're a supporter or a fan of, you know, you use this strategy, the next day, the other day, you go use another strategy, oh, this other strategy does not work, then let me find out another strategy from this other channel and put it together. And you know, things don't work that way. You have to stick with one strategy, even though the strategy is at its bad stage. And just to remind you guys, if you guys haven't tapped that subscribe button, just tapping the subscribe button, you guys should do that. Whenever I see one person subscribe, seriously, I'm mad happy. I used to be. I don't encourage anyone to trade with price action. It's near next to gambling. I feel like that so much. But when you're using an indicator that actually shows you everything, you know, you're combining two or three indicators that actually shows you the same thing, that's confidence. Not looking at price, and price action works to a part, to a bit, but let's take the reality of things. So without talking too much, let's move back to the strategy. And you guys know I'm using the Android, so if you're using the iOS or if you're using any other device that accepts MetaTrader 4, just go find the indicator section. So I'm going to move over to my indicator section, which is this F button over here. Then yes, you want to go over to the relative strength index. Go over to the relative strength index. Although this strategy is not only the relative strength index, it's not only the use of relative strength index. Me alone, if you're using relative strength index alone, like come on, you might get fake out. So we actually compound these two indicators so that we know that we know when one is giving us a fake out, and you know, give a standard approach to that. So the relative strength index number is 14. Make pexel should be 2. Then once you're done with that, just simply add default. So if you just tap default, it gives you everything you need to see. So let's just go on the done. So you see the relative strength index is uploaded onto our chart, clean, nice. And what you don't want your chart to look like is a mess. So you don't, your chart should not look like a mess. Let's continue further. So you have to still go over to the indicator section. I don't know if same thing. So let's move on to the moving average. So moving average, okay, so let's, although I've already had this one set up, I want you guys to take a look at the period. The period is 20, the shift is 0, the method is simple, apply to close, then the pixels is 2, and the color is also green. So if you put it basically at default, to start by the period will be 10. But I want you guys to shift that 10, period 10 to 20. So once you've done that, just hit on done. So it actually shows there. But I still want you to do another thing. Go over to the indicator section again, and then move over to the moving average. Then you can just simply keep this one to be 25. So since it's already showing at 20, so let's change to 25. So 25 pixels to, let's make it red. You understand? Let's make it red. So let's hit down the done button. Although if you're starting at default, it actually shows you a different thing altogether. So this is what I mean, you're trading with confirmation, not trading with sentiment. Sentiment does not work in the market. Understand? I don't know if you understand that, but by the time you're using this strategy, you guys will understand what I mean fully by that. So like I said, if you watch my previous video, let me pull up this arrow. I love this arrow, it's crazy. So if you watch my previous video, I actually say that the relative strength index, whenever the relative strength index is at the 70, you don't just go, you know, you don't just go sell the market, because at that point of 70 is actually overbought. So I don't recommend you, you know, selling the market like so fast. Once price is at the 70, and I don't recommend you buying the market once price at the 30. So these are two things you need to take into consideration. This is where people get freaked out. You know, they see price at 70, they sell, but price continue moving up. That's a freak out from the relative strength index. So that's why you have three on this indicator to show us the main direction of the market, instead of getting freak out here and there from different crazy indicators. So first off, I want to start off by explaining the moving average. I'll explain the moving average and I'll explain the RSI, then I'll explain everything together. So I hope you guys are taking notes. You know, if you're with your pen or your paper, make sure you write this down. Or if you're with listening here, I want you guys to do that more attentively this moment. And yeah, keep on. If you guys want to understand this video more, if you want to download it, watch it a couple of times so you can get better understanding of the strategy and make sure you use it to make money off this forex market. So I want you guys to look at the moving average. You see, we have in the moving average section. Okay, we're there. So at the moving average section, we are seeing the green moving average, a moving average with green, and a moving average with red. So I want you guys to look at it. So basically, we are working with this moving average, with these two moving averages we are having here. We are looking at crossovers. We're looking at the crossovers with the moving average and the candlestick. So I want you guys to look at the point where, you know, we had a crossover. So if you look at this point here, we had a crossover, right? I want to take you guys to another point. You see this point here, we had a crossover. So what does this crossover mean? The crossover means change in trend. So whenever we are having a crossover within the moving average, there is going to be a change in trend. You can see that from this point here. I think I can use my arrow, right? I remember when MetaTrader 4 just trends change everything. The spot where I knew this was coming. I knew this was coming. That's why I don't like, you know, using the MetaTrader 4, I've already made a video concerning whether you should use MetaTrader 4 or TradingView. So just go watch that video out. You guys will see my reactions to those things. So I don't think this is working. So anyway, I'll still delete it, but you guys will see it. So look at the place where, you know, price crossed. You can see the place where the moving average crossed. So what happened there? There was a change in trend, right? So let's move back to this point here. So once the moving average crossed again, we could also find out that the trend changed. So this is another note that you guys should be taking. So take note of this. Whenever there is a crossover in a moving average, it simply means there will be a change in trend sooner or later. So that's what it is. And yes, another thing you have to know, that price is actually moving in an uptrend, is when the candlestick is above these two moving averages. So once the candlestick is above the two moving averages complete, the price is moving in an uptrend. And once the price is moving below the moving averages, come on, the price is moving in a downtrend. So I hope you guys were able to understand it. So if you were not able to understand it, I will actually advise you to go back again. You can rewind and watch what I said. Just do that so you guys can get a clear understanding of this. So yes, first confirmation is price moving above, you can see price moving above the moving averages. And then the second confirmation, or crossover of the moving average, first confirmation to take a buy is when the once price goes above the moving average, and when there is a crossover of the moving average. So crossover of the opposite direction of to the other direction of the moving average. So once you see the crossover, there's a change in trend. And if you find out that the candlestick is above this moving average, that means it's an uptrend. Then if you find out that there's a crossover in the moving average and the candlestick is below the moving average, that is the trend is simply changing to be a downtrend. So yes, I've already explained the moving averages, but you can also use the moving average as a support or a resistance. Oh my god, I just see this MetaTrader 4 can be so crazy. So yes, and also you can also use this moving average as a support and a resistance. If you check it, whenever price goes or touches the moving average, sometimes, you know, price tends to bounce
off of that zone. Come on.
And yes, I've already discussed about the moving average, and I know you're probably wondering, why is relative strength index included? So you actually use relative strength index to find the overbought and the oversold zone. But although we know we already said the 70 is the overbought and the 30 is the oversold, but although you know, you don't just go selling at the overbought zone so fast. As you could see here, at this point it already marked that the market is at an overbought zone, and if you had sell the market, come on, you're reading the losses high. You're seriously reading the losses. Like, you know what I mean by that. But let's take it for a fact that maybe the moving average was not uploaded into our screen and we are just using the relative strength index all through. Come on. The relative strength index gives good signal and it also gives fake out, but this is to filter every single thing about the relative strength index. So let me give you guys a deep dive on it. So the same, the relative strength index is at the 70 mark. This actually means that price will soon or will later go down. So when you actually have to take this relative strength index in serious consideration is when price have moved below the moving average. So once you see that price have gotten below the moving average, just watch how the relative strength index will start to tank. So once you see that tanking on the distance on the relative strength index, this screen. Once you see the moving average is below the once you see the candlestick is below the moving average, just watch and wait how the relative strength index start tanking and start going down the drain. And yes, this is simple, same and similar to it. You see that price is actually at the 30.030. You see that price is actually at the 30 mark, and this does not actually mean you should, you know, start buying up the market. No, this is not what it means. It means that you should actually wait for price to go above the moving average. And you can see the moving average. I want you guys to take a look at the moving average. So looking at the moving average, price is nowhere next to moving up. So it's when we find out that price is going above this moving average, then you can consider buying according to what the RSI sees. So let's move further to see whether we could see any of those happening. You could see, you can see how price is just at the 30 zone, but yes, price was unable to, you know, break fully and go past above the moving average in full terms. So let's look for a point where that happened. So I want you guys to take note of this zone. Look at this zone here. Let me bring up my arrow. So you guys could see it there, that in this zone, this is crazy, don't know, this is crazy, but I feel so stressed out. Okay, so you could see, I want you guys to take a look at the relative strength index, and look at, once price moved above the moving average, just watch how closely the relative strength index try to move to the 70 mark. So this is what I mean. Using the relative strength index alone can bring about a lot of fake outs, but using this moving average and this strategy that I've given you guys, this will help you guys to make the right choices and the right direction in the forex, whether you're a forex day trader, crypto day trader, or even a stock day trader. This will help you guys a lot. So if you guys want to help a brother or anyone close to you, I consider sharing this video if you know that they really need this information. So just sharing this video alone will help them a lot, and that's what I believe you should do. So let me summarize everything real quick. So in summary, you actually take a position once you see, you know, the moving average crossovers of the moving average, price going above the moving average, and then the relative strength index showing the overbought and oversold zone without you taking the information directly, but just using the moving average to know when the relative strength index is actually giving you fake out. So if you did love this video, giving this video a like will surely help, and sharing this video to other people who might need this type of video will also help the person next in need. And also, whenever I see one person subscribe, seriously, I'm always happy. So if you smash that subscribe button, you don't know where I am, but wherever I was or wherever I am, I'm just smiling. So I hope you guys do that, and with that being said, man, I'm out.